customers already have over 700 million Lightning headphones. And there are also over 2 billion Apple power adapters out in the world. So we are removing these items from the iPhone box, which reduces carbon emissions and avoids the mining and use of precious materials.
Now, every iPhone will include the more advanced and higher power USB-C to Lightning cable.
Hey, what is up, internet? Welcome back to the channel. And I usually don't make such videos, but ye ek topic hai jo mujhe kafi time se pareshan kar raha hai. So I finally decided I'll make a video on it. So Apple unveiled their new iPhone lineup, the iPhone 12, earlier this month, and it comes with all the bells and whistles as always. But jo rumors aa rahi thi, it is true. The new iPhone 12 will not have the charging brick inside the box. So no earpods, no charging brick, just the iPhone and the USB Type-C to Lightning cable. And logon ne bahut tarikon se internet pe iske upar react kiya tha. But why did Apple do this? Apple ne aisa kyun kiya? Well, it's mostly because they want to contribute to the environment. Now, removing these things from the box would make sense according to them, because we already have a lot of chargers and we already have a lot of earpods lying around in the house. So removing these items from the box will help them reduce carbon emissions. And also removing these items from the box will help them reduce the packaging of the iPhone, so they can fit in more iPhones in that same truck or the same shipping pallet. So basically, Apple wants to become 100% carbon neutral by 2030. And this is one of the only steps in the beginning that they want to do to achieve that. So this does sound like a really good move, right? Because everyone wants to contribute to the environment. In fact, Stephen Hank, the CEO of Anchor, actually recently sat with The Verge on a podcast and claimed that we have just over 3 lakh tons of e-waste just from these chargers that come with the box or phones or other laptops or other gadgets lying around in the house. So it's a massive deal when it comes to environment, because 3 lakh tons of e-waste is, I think, a big concern, I would say. So on the onset, it feels that this move by Apple would make sense in 2020, because we all want that one of the biggest tech giants in the world, if they can contribute to the environment, everyone would also follow. But some of the decisions from Apple actually don't give you that impression. Now, first, they included a USB-C to Lightning cable in the box with the iPhone 12. While on the other hand, every iPhone before 12 came with the USB-A charging brick. So technically, you can't use your old Apple charging brick with the new cable that comes with the iPhone 12. Okay, that's weird. So you would either have to buy a separate charging brick, which I think is ₹1900 here in India, or you would want to use your new iPhone 12 with the old charging brick that came with iPhone 11 or other previous iPhones. But that will not offer you fast charging. And second, I think Apple easily could have opted for USB-C, because including a USB-C on the iPhones, now that they have also included it on iPad and iPad Pro, and also of course MacBooks, would easily solve the entire problem. But again, this is Apple. They do not come easy. Now, some people would also say that they also didn't reduce the price of the iPhone, but I think they did bring in their trademark AMOLED display instead of the LCD HD display that we saw on the iPhone 11. And also the new 5G chips, I think, would cost a little bit extra to the company. So I will not rant Apple on the price as such. But overall, so if iPhone 12 will be your first iPhone, you will have to shed ₹1900 extra to buy that extra charging brick. Or if you already have iPhone 11 or any other previous iPhones, you would still have to buy that extra ₹900 charging brick. Only if you have Pixel, because Pixel, I remember, come with the USB-C charging brick, or if you plan to charge your iPhone with MacBook only, would not require you to get the new charging brick. But I think That doesn't make sense. So what could have Apple done instead? I think Apple could have easily given the option to at least get the charger in the box. I mean, like, leave it to the buyers, right? Let them decide if they want the charger in the box. Or the least they could have done is give a discount to someone who's buying the charger alongside the iPhone 12 or any other iPhone from the iPhone lineup. I think that would have made more sense, but I think Apple is looking at something else. And this was rightly mentioned by MKBHD in one of his videos as well, that Apple is actually looking for a portless iPhone in the next couple of years or so. So giving USB-C or giving a discount, they just want you to get used to the wireless world, and this year's solution is the MagSafe. But I'm not concerned about that. I'm not an Apple fanboy and I don't really use Apple products. But then why I am making this video? Because I'm concerned that after this move by Apple, a lot of the other companies will follow it. We all know what happened with the notch. We all know what happened with the headphone jack. Because Apple is such huge as a company, it has that power to change a trend in the tech industry. So right now, Samsung is making fun of Apple for not including the charger in the box. Even OnePlus and Xiaomi are making fun of Apple for not including the charger in the box. But we all know what happened with Pixel 2, where they conveniently made fun of Apple for removing the headphone jack, but then the next year they removed the headphone jack from the Pixel lineup, which is stupid, I guess. So I don't know, because every time Apple does this outrageous thing in the tech industry, everyone tends to follow it. And I'm afraid and I'm worried, if this is true, will my next phone will have a charger in the box? Well, I don't know. If you ask me, like, Samsung is already planning to remove charger from some of its phones. But if you ask me, it's coming. And for sure, it's good for environment in the longer run. I'm not saying that. But the point is, who will do it in a better way? Will everyone follow an approach that is more practical? Or will everyone follow an approach just like Apple to just earn a little extra revenue? Well, let me know in the comment section below. So guys, this was a quick video where I wanted to share my thoughts on this situation, because yes, the new iPhones are out and everyone is as excited as they could have been by any other iPhone launch we have seen in the past. But I think this topic needed that attention, and that's the exact reason why I'm making this video, nothing else. So no hard feelings for Apple or anything, but yeah, I'm just worried. And let me know in the comment section below, what do you think? Will we have chargers in our smartphone boxes going like from next year or so? So yes guys, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. And if you like such content, I would want to see more such content in your YouTube feed, make sure you hit that subscribe button and subscribe to TechiNet, and especially hit that bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload such videos in future as well. So till then, keep asking, and I will see you in the next one.